Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market continues to trade sideways. So the prices of most of the major cryptocurrencies have been moving sideways for the last over, let's say, 2 or 3 weeks. I want to say that yesterday I analyzed the price chart of Bitcoin, and that's why today let's analyze the price chart of Ethereum in detail. Just to outline that the current price is $171. Ethereum has recorded a price increase by 10.4% for the last 7 days and a price decrease by 5.4% for the last 24 hours. And this is actually how the price chart of Ethereum looks like in the daily time frame. So let's start. Let's start from the broader picture, from the monthly time frame, and let's check the latest candlesticks. Now, what I want to remind you that we had this bearish bullish engulfing at the very beginning of the year in January. Then we had a shooting star in February. And I want to remind you that at that time, I mentioned, or actually I pointed out, that this candlestick, although it is a shooting star and it is considered to be a trend reversal candlestick, it has a bullish body that is above the bullish body of this candlestick formation called bearish engulfing. So to some extent, that was a signal that the bulls were prevailing over the bears significantly during this period. And that's why in March, when the bears took control over the market, they couldn't push significantly the price down. What I mean is that if we check the price chart of Bitcoin, this candlestick has a body and a closing price significantly below the closing price of those two candlesticks. Here, the closing price for the candlestick for March is still a little bit above the opening price for the month of January. That's why now the rebound that the price of Ethereum is experiencing is significantly higher or bigger than if compared to the rebound of the price of Bitcoin. And now we have for the month of April a bullish candlestick with significant bullish body. Of course, it is much smaller if compared to this bearish body, but at least it is already in the middle of the range of this body. So to some extent, it indicates that there is some kind of consensus between the bulls and the bears. Once again, here we had this bullish engulfing followed by a shooting star, and then we had this bearish engulfing. So this is the bearish engulfing. And if we take into account all those controversial signals, the bullish ones, the bearish ones, and this rebound at the moment, I think it simply indicates this set of signals indicates that there is some kind of uncertainty in the market. The market participants are struggling to find the clear direction, and probably we will witness in the next few weeks and months continuation of this volatility. And we will not, at the moment, I think that there is no clear signal in which direction the market will continue. That's why this monthly time frame is very important, because it outlines that there is no clear signal, neither bearish nor bullish. But this is just my point of view. Now let's switch to the weekly time frame. The situation is also very interesting. So this is the price increase that happened in the first, couple of weeks of the year, or actually till the middle of February. Then the bears were able to regain control over the bulls and they push the price significantly down. Then the price tested the local low from December 2018, and now the price is rebounding. And what I want to say is that since the middle of March, we have in the price chart the sequence of candlesticks, bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. Of course, the current candlestick is a bearish one and it has a local high below the previous local high, but still a local low above the previous one. That's why I think that to some extent it indicates that bulls are still controlling the market in the weekly time frame. But I just want to remind you that in my previous analysis of Ethereum, I outlined that this opening price of this candlestick is a very solid resistance line. So it is approximately at the psychological level of $200 per one digital coin. That's why when the price of Ethereum is approaching this level, we have to be quiet. We have to keep an eye on the behavior of the price, because I'm not pretty sure that the price chart will easily break through this line. So this is a solid resistance line. And now let's move to the daily time frame. And I just want to remind you that as most of the major cryptocurrencies, Ethereum has been in this downtrend as well. So this is actually the trajectory of the downtrend. So we have this descending channel. Of course, we can draw additional line through the middle of this, let's say, channel. And at the moment, Ethereum is close to the middle of this channel. And it is quite similar if compared to the price chart of Bitcoin in the daily time frame. That's why there is, of course, big correlation between the price of the major cryptocurrencies. But my main point that I want to outline, or the message I want to convey, is that it is a descending channel. So it means that the bears are controlling the market in the daily time frame. So the buyers have to be really very careful in this, let's say, bear market or descending channel or downtrend. And the last time frame I will comment on is the 4 hour time frame. The situation is almost the same as if compared to the 4 hour price chart of Bitcoin. There is a correction, so it is in the form of ascending channel. So this is the ascending channel. Now the price is very close to the lower line of the ascending channel. That's why it is worth mentioning that we have to keep an eye on the price chart. If the price chart will be able to rebound once it reaches the lower line of the descending channel, or of course if we see that the price breaks through this lower line, then it will be the first signal indicating that the bear trend is resuming, is about to resume. And that's it for today, fellas, about the price chart of Ethereum. To sum up, in most of the time frames, for example, in the monthly time frame, we don't have any clear signals. In the weekly time frame, we have a kind of rebound, but still the situation is not that clear. In the daily time frame, we have these descending channels, so it is a bearish signal. And in the 4 hour time frame, we have a kind of potential ascending channel or uptrend, so it's a slight bullish signal. And if we sum up all this information, it means that there is no clear signal, there is no clear direction. And that's why, in my view, we have to be very careful. That's it for today. And please share your view on the price chart of Ethereum as a comment under this video. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next one. Thank you for watching. It was me at CryptoSpark.